back to Sports Weekly, the show that features the top athletes, coaches, and teams in the Comcast coverage area. And we start this program in northern New Jersey. Many of the state's top fencers are going cross-country this weekend to take part in the Junior Olympics. Paul Spahala caught up with three of those young athletes from Millburn.
The Millburn fencing team boasts some of the top individual talent in the state of New Jersey, while at the same time showing the depth that could lead to a team title.
In order to place second in boys and girls through through 50 teams, you have to have balance, and we do have balance throughout the five weapons.
Senior captain Mitch Lepp finished seventh last year in the state FA competition.
He's the best FA fencer that we've had here at Millburn. He has a very flamboyant FA style, where FA is normally a passive, slower pace, and he's very, very quick and very smart.
I guess my footwork has gotten a lot better. My point control, I've been fencing a lot, so I have a lot more experience. Well, you know, when you fence a lot of different people, you get used to a lot of different styles. And you know, when you fence someone for the first time, you have to be able to adapt. And really the best way to do that is just to fence as many different people as you can.
Also leading the way for the Millers is Steve Mawcone, who won the New Jersey foil title last winter and is one of only two returning individual state champions.
Since last year, I've been doing a lot more batting and getting a lot more experience. I've actually been going to New York a lot more to practice with the clubs there.
Emily Katz adds to the battle for individual honors in foil with her return from the national circuit.
I think it helped a lot. It was a great experience, and I got to fence a lot of great fencers, and I trained really hard, which helped me to, I guess by doing that, I hope to help the team do better this year.
One of the interesting aspects of the sport is that individual honors often come with little recognition.
It's just the greatest sport because I've done other sports, and you know, it's individual and also a team sport, which makes it very unique and very special.
I've known from when I started fencing that it wasn't a high publicity sport. And I really got into it because I loved the sport, not necessarily because I wanted recognition.
The positive side is that this sport pretty much feeds college scholarships more than any other sport. And a lot of people don't know that, but Millburn people do know it. And if they want to get into top Ivy schools, this is a real good avenue to do it.
Several Millburn fencers have already qualified for the Junior Olympics to be held this weekend in Oakland, California. For Comcast Scholastic Sports Weekly, I'm Paul Spahala.
Thank you, Paul. Now we move on to boys basketball in Central New Jersey, and it's been a great year for boys hoops in the Shore Conference. Recently, Steve Tober visited with the Bulldogs of